my number one tip for an entrepreneur is don't make yourself or your family suffer just to call yourself an entrepreneur. Like, even me, I've just gone fully self-employed, but it was taking so long. I might see a client today, they want to do an investment, but the transfer from one provider to the other can take 2 or 3 months, and I don't get paid until the transfer is completed. So sometimes, you know, money was so irregular that my family were just suffering, you know what I mean? Because we just didn't have money at the time, and we're trying to wait for it to come in, and it will come in and we'll be all right. And then, do you know what I mean? And actually, I just had to just go and get a job. I had to humble myself and go back and get my 9-to-5 and do that for a period of time whilst I built Noir to the point where the following was big enough and people understood what I do and how I can help. And then I had people who referred people and said, look, I've used the service and it works, and I've bought a house, or I've paid off my debt, or my pension's grown, or I finally managed to amalgamate all my savings or my pensions, or I know where I'm investing. And when people start to speak, then other people listen, and then you start to build it in. And now I've got a pipeline where I know money's coming in regular. So now I can go self-employed because I can do that. But it's taken almost 2 years to get to this point. So I say my number one tip is don't go too early, but also if you are working, look around you, look at what you can learn. If you're in a business, learn, how is that business surviving? How are they able to pay you a salary? What's their outgoings? What's their costs? What have they done? Speak to the senior management, see how they've got to it. Learn the history, because you can basically model your business on a business that already exists. I think sometimes we're always trying to create something brand new, but actually some of the best inventions are just slight tweaks of existing businesses. Uber is not new. We've always got cabs, and do you know what I mean? But the app is new. Do you know what I mean? And sometimes the best businesses out there are not brand new businesses. They're tweaks of existing things. And I always told myself, if I help people and I focus on helping people, the money is a byproduct. And so a lot of the time, if you can find something that you can service and actually help people, the money will come afterwards. Because once you start helping people and people realize, sometimes people don't even realize there's a need. Like when I started, people were like, why would I pay for a seminar? Now my seminars get sold out most of the time because people realize, actually, I don't know enough. And so it takes time. Sometimes you have to educate your audience to understand the need that they didn't know that they had, because they're happy with the life that they're living, not knowing that there's a better life out there. So I think definitely those two things. One, don't go too early. And two, if you're in a business, learn from that and find ways to kind of model your business, even if it's bad. Some of your bad experiences, make sure when you go into business, you don't take those bad traits with you.